What time is it? Seriously, does anyone have the time?
Does everybody know what time it is?
Showtime! No, no, it's not. Well, the more I think about it, actually, it could be tool time. I'll explain more about why that is at a later time, but right now it's time for me to tell you that I am Mr. Beat. And if you're watching this, even if you're watching this at the exact same time, if I were to ask you what time it is, many of you would tell me different answers. And the reason why is because you're watching from different time zones. But hold up, what is a time zone? Well, a time zone is a region of the Earth where everyone agrees it's the same time. Also referred to as, quote, local time, most time zones are exactly 1 hour apart. It's why time travel is possible.
Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler. I sent him into the future.
But Einstein is not the world's first time traveler. People travel through time all the time, thanks to time zones. Yep, just by going west, you can go back in time. But be careful, because if you go too far west, you've gone to the future. But don't worry, you can always return to the past by going back east. Oh crap, I'm losing many of you. Okay, let's start simple. There are 24 hours in a day.
Right now, terrorists are plotting to assassinate a presidential candidate. My wife and daughter have been targeted, and people that I work with may be involved in both. I'm Federal Agent Jack Bauer, and today is the longest day of my life.
Now, we've been dividing each day into 24 hours going back to, like, the ancient Egyptians. And because most of us still measure how long a day is by hours, the idea is that there would be 24 time zones around the Earth, you know, since the Earth rotates about 15 degrees every hour. After 24 hours, that's a full rotation of 360 degrees for a full day. So you'd have 24 lunes, or shapes that look like this, all 15 degrees of longitude apart, and boom, we all live happily ever after. But no, that's not how time zones are shaped. In fact, there are more than 24 time zones. Yeah, as many as 39 different time zones. Now, originally, there were 24 standard time zones that extended from the South Pole to the North Pole, but due to mainly politics and geography, time zones are often very skewed. But before we get into why that is, this video is sponsored in part by Morning Brew. Yep, I've discovered a new fantastic way to consume the news. Morning Brew is a free daily newsletter that gets you up to speed on business, finance, and tech in just 5 minutes. While the traditional news can often be a bit boring, especially in finance, Morning Brew is witty, relevant, and informative. Just look at how entertained I am reading it. Every story is interesting to me, like this one, where I learned that apparently a bunch of colleges still give special preference to admitting students whose parents previously went there? Dang. Oh, and I also enjoy the puzzle section. Morning Brew is completely free, and it takes less than 15 seconds to subscribe. So do it! Sign up for free by clicking the link in the description of this video. And now it's time to get back to time zones. First, let's go into a brief history of time zones. First, it's important to remember that before the invention of the railroad, time zones weren't really needed. If you traveled before railroads were invented, you traveled by, walking. You know, something we now do for, quote, exercise. If you were lucky, you might get to travel by horse, or if you were even luckier, you might even get to travel by ship. But by the time railroads were more common in the 1830s and 1840s, this made travel time way faster and really screwed up communication about what time it was. But the British had been thinking about this problem long before the railroads came. As they established an empire around the world beginning in the 1600s, some back in London realized they needed to standardize a way of measuring time to help mariners when they were determining longitude when out at sea. So they'd reference wherever they were back to London. It wasn't until 1721, however, that Great Britain officially created its own prime meridian, or Earth's 0 degrees longitude, passing through their newly established Royal Observatory in Greenwich, a borough in London. Other countries established their own prime meridian, of course, usually passing through their capital cities, and yeah, they called it different things, like France and China. See, they even publish maps with 0 degree longitude running right through their capitals. So just to be clear, the prime meridian also would establish something on the opposite end of the globe, the 180 degree longitudinal line called the International Dateline. That is where today becomes tomorrow, or today becomes yesterday. So if you go west crossing it, you add a day. If you go east crossing it, you subtract a day. Flash forward to the 1840s, and now we had railroads to worry about. At every railway stop, the local time would be different. That, combined with the fact that a lack of standardized time could lead to, I don't know, two trains colliding or something, led to railroad companies establishing the first time zones that matched their imaginary prime meridians that ran through their capital cities. They also created these time zones due to the invention of the telegraph, being able to send messages far, far away, by the way. Still, of all these prime meridians, the British prime meridian got more respect, man. It was, I guess, the primest of the prime. And a big reason why it was this dude, Sir George Airy, who used science and stuff to get a more accurate measurement. Great Britain established Greenwich Mean Time, based on Airy's prime meridian, as the local solar time, or the local time based on the position of the sun in the sky. By the end of the 1850s, nearly every single British citizen was measuring time in reference to Greenwich Mean Time. But wait a second, what if a British person wanted to leave their country? Like, if they went to France, their watch would totally be wrong. Well, yes, like I said earlier, several different countries had already established their own time zones, including France. Heck, giant railroad companies in both the United States and Canada already had their own time zones going and were doing just fine and dandy. Kind of. But because the American and Canadian governments had stayed out of it, this often led to confusion for ordinary folks trying to travel to and do business with different parts of the world, the country, or even the county. Well, I'm assuming the Scottish-Canadian inventor Sir Sandford Fleming was one of the folks tired of being confused about what time it was all over the world, and he's the first one I could find that went around trying to convince the world, we all gotta get on the same page, or clock, if you will. Now, credit to the Italian mathematician Quirico Filippanti, who proposed 24-hourly time zones as well a few years prior, but it was Fleming who went around promoting it, writing articles and books about it. He proposed the international dateline I told you about earlier, in this case opposite of the globe of the Greenwich Mean Time, where today becomes tomorrow. Well, Fleming must have got the American government's attention, because they told President Chester Arthur to go hold an international convention on the matter. In October 1884, he did just that, and representatives from 25 different countries got together and agreed to pick one standard prime meridian that time zones would be based off of. And which one did they go with? Oh, you already know, don't you? I'm wasting my time and your time telling you, but I'm gonna tell you anyway. They went with the primest of the prime, the one Sir George Airy established, Greenwich Mean Time, GMT baby, the same one that passed through the Royal Observatory in Greenwich, England. It became the international standard for the prime meridian and thus the official reference when measuring time around the world. Later, Coordinated Universal Time, aka UTC, made these measurements even more precise. And they all lived happily ever after. Well, not really.
You see, many countries refused to immediately jump on board. Sure, they had some kind of standard time zone, but only some of them used an hourly offset from GMT. I mean, take France. They sure as heck weren't giving up their Paris Meridian. You know what I'm saying? They clung onto it for decades. Even today, some salty French cartographers continue to use it. It wasn't until the 1920s that most countries finally started to use GMT. Heck, Liberia didn't adopt it until 1972. Liberia, come on.
Meanwhile, just because today the world is mostly on the same page when it comes to time zones, doesn't mean that each country doesn't entirely screw things up within their borders.
Time zones are often skewed. Take China and India, the two most populous countries in the world that are also big enough in land area to exceed the ideal 15 degrees of longitude for 1 hour. Yeah, both countries have only one time zone. Crossing the border between China and Afghanistan, yeah, you forgot they bordered each other, didn't you? Means a 3.5 hour change, since China is 8 hours ahead of UTC and Afghanistan is 4.5 hours ahead of it. So crossing from Afghanistan into China would mean instantly losing 3.5 hours. Wait, half an hour? Yeah, some countries use standard time zones not to the nearest hour, but to the nearest half hour. Then there's Russia, which has 11 time zones, but just like that, removed two of them in 2010, only to bring them back again in 2014. And Australia. What the heck are you doing, Australia? Oh, you just all think you can do whatever you want, don't you? There's even an unofficial time zone called Australian Central Western Standard Time, which is only in this small strip of land where it's 8.75 hours ahead of UTC, even though only about 200 people live in the area. And then, of course, in the Pacific Ocean. Like, these islands should logically be with today, but set their clocks to yesterday. And here, it's supposed to be today, but it's actually tomorrow. And don't even get me started on freaking daylight saving time. I mean, what is going on with all of this? Well, basically, due to geographical, political, and even social reasons, time zones often are different from what international institutions recommend. In other words, it's often governments that ultimately determine time zones, not scientists.
Man, time zones are more random than I had previously thought. The more I think about it, the more I wonder if we really need time zones. I mean, can't I just call my friend who lives in a different part of the country and we both just agree that it's the same time, regardless of where the sun is in the sky? I mean, the sun is overrated anyway. I'm gonna call a friend about this, actually. I got my phone here. I'm gonna call my friend Nick and see what he has to say about this. Hey, Nick? Nick?
Hello, yes?
What time is it where you live?
10:15?
Well, it's 9:15 where I live, and I think this is really messing up our collaboration.
What do you suppose we do about that?
I don't know. You're the science teacher.
If you're asking me, I think we should do away with time zones. They're overrated anyway.
Go on.
I will, but over on my channel. Maybe you can tell your viewers to come on over when they're done watching your video?
Okay, sure. I'll send them over. Does this mean it's time for our conversation to end?
Yes, it's time.
Okay, bye.
See you next time.
That was my friend Nick from the YouTube channel Science Asylum, and he just released a video at the same time as this one, and it's called Do We Need Time Zones? Spoiler alert, we don't, But he goes into detail as to why that is. So check it out when you're done watching this video. I'll put the link in the description.
In conclusion, time zones can be frustrating, but it's how we have attempted to deal with the fact that we can travel around the world much quicker than we used to, and the fact that we can now instantly communicate with others on the other side of the world. But really, it's about the fact that we are nostalgic for a time when we couldn't travel around the world quickly or instantly communicate with others on the other side of the world. You see, it's all about perception. We want the sun to appear straight above us in the sky at noon, and we want it to be completely dark out at 3 a.m. It doesn't have to be, though, does it? Just like Christmas doesn't have to be in the winter. Just ask anyone in the Southern Hemisphere about that. But a lot of Northern Hemisphere folks would be pretty darn upset if they never had a white Christmas.
So time zones are a way to adapt to modern technology while still clinging to the past. And I gotta say, it's about time I made a video about time zones. Okay, now it's time I wrap this video up. But what do you think? Do we still need time zones? Before you make up your mind, perhaps you should watch Science Asylum's video he just released at the same time as this one, answering that question, do we still need time zones? I've put the link in the description of this video. Check it out and subscribe to his channel. And now it's time for my monthly shout out to all my Patreon supporters who donate at least $15 or more each month to my channel. I am eternally grateful to all of you, starting with my $20 a month supporters, just alphabetically here. Alexander Major, Alicia Solberg, Andrew B, Anthony Beckett, Austin Ceros, Brady Bardwell, Corey Ryman, Dr. Paul J. Lilly, Elijah Ellis, Josie Ramsey, Kyle Fassbinder, Matt Standish, Neo R14, Nick Everett, Osbers Gaming, Pat Iapica, Sean Connett, Thomas, Will Scruggs, and William Roush. At the $15 a month level, I've got Adam Christians, Aesthetic Degan, Andrew Snyder, Brian Layton, Christian Ojeda, Gail Gerard, Grant Hughes, Ian Driscoll, Elon Capone, Jack L., Jack Richardson, Jacob Birnbaum, Joel Serrano Lozada, John Johnson, Justin Holt, Kit Walker, Lee Fortier, Naderade, Nelson Guzman, Robert Reichel, Samuel Striz, Thomas Oppenheim, Victor Martinez, Waterfort, Werner 69, and Zachary F. Parker. Thank you all for donating, and thank you for watching.